Well, I'm going to tell you the story of Peter and the Wolf. In the tale you're about to hear, each character is represented by a different instrument in the orchestra. The bird by the flute. The duck by the oboe. The cat by the clarinet. Grandfather by the bassoon. The wolf by the horn. The gunshots by the timpani and the bass drum. And Peter by the strings in the orchestra. Now to begin our story. Early one morning, Peter opened the gate and went out into the big green meadow. On the branch of a big tree sat a little bird, Peter's friend. "All is quiet," chirped the bird gaily. Soon a duck came waddling around. She was glad that Peter had not closed the gate and decided to take a nice swim in the deep pond in the meadow. Seeing the duck, the little bird flew down upon the grass, settled next to the duck, and shrugged his shoulders. "What kind of a bird are you if you can't fly?" said he. To this the duck replied, "What kind of a bird are you if you can't swim?" and dived into the pond. They argued and argued, the duck swimming in the pond, the little bird hopping along the shore. Suddenly, something caught Peter's attention. He noticed a cat crawling through the grass. The cat thought, "The bird is busy arguing. I'll just grab him." Stealthily, she crept toward him on her velvet paws. "Look out!" shouted Peter, and the bird immediately flew up into the tree. While the duck quacked angrily at the cat from the middle of the pond. The cat crawled around the tree and thought, "Is it worth climbing up so high? By the time I get there, the bird will have flown away." Grandfather came out. He was angry because Peter had gone into the meadow. "It is a dangerous place." "What if a wolf came out of the forest? Then what would you do?" Peter paid no attention to his grandfather's words. Boys like him are not afraid of wolves. But Grandfather took Peter by the hand, led him home, and locked the gate. No sooner had Peter gone than a big gray wolf came out of the forest. In a twinkling, the cat climbed up the tree. The duck quacked, and in their excitement, jumped out of the pond. But no matter how hard the duck tried to run, she couldn't escape the wolf. He was getting nearer, nearer. Catching up with her. And then he got her and with one gulp swallowed her down. And now this is how things stood. The cat was sitting on one branch. The bird on another. Not too close to the cat. While the wolf walked around and around the tree, looking at them with greedy eyes. In the meantime, Peter, without the slightest fear, stood behind the closed gate, watching all that was going on. He ran home, got a strong rope, and climbed up the high stone wall. One of the branches of the tree around which the wolf was walking stretched out over the wall. Grabbing hold of the branch, Peter lightly climbed over onto the tree. Peter said to the bird, "Fly down and circle around the wolf's head. Only take care he doesn't catch you." The bird almost touched the wolf's head with his wings. While the wolf snapped angrily at him, from this side and that, how the bird did worry the wolf, how he wanted to catch him, but the bird was too clever, and the wolf simply couldn't do anything about it. Meanwhile, Peter made a lasso. And carefully letting it down. Caught the wolf by the tail and pulled with all his might. Feeling himself caught, the wolf began to jump wildly, trying to get loose. But Peter tied the other end of the rope to the tree. And the wolf's jumping only made the rope tighter around his tail. Just then, the hunters came out of the woods. Following the wolf's trail and shooting as they came. Thank you. But Peter, sitting in the tree, said, "Don't shoot. Bertie and I have already caught the wolf. Now help us take him to the zoo." And now off they went to the zoo. Imagine the triumphant procession. Peter at the head. After him, the hunters leading the wolf. And winding up the procession, Grandfather and the Cat. Grandfather tossed his head and grumbled, "What if Peter had not caught the wolf? What then?" Above them flew Bertie, chirping merrily. "My, what brave fellows we are, Peter and I. Look what we have caught." And if you would listen very carefully, you could hear the duck quacking inside the wolf. Mm-hmm. because in his haste, the wolf had swallowed her. Alive!
Did you have a great time? All right. Well, the fun's not over, so come join us out in the lobby, get some autographs, say hello, and come back to see us again. Thanks so much. Have a great day.